Hey everyone, welcome to Intellipaat, and we are back again with another interesting video on a versus topic. So you guys must be aware about a buzzword going on these days, which is deep learning, right? And 2015 was a time when we actually observed some of the biggest evolutions in the industry of AI and deep learning. How? By the introduction to two of the most popular libraries, which are Keras and Tensorflow. Which one to choose and when to choose, that is what we're going to cover up in this video on Keras versus Tensorflow. So guys, before we proceed further, do subscribe to Intellipaat's YouTube channel so that you never miss out on any of our upcoming videos. Alright guys, now let's have a look at the agenda for this video. First and foremost, we're going to discuss what exactly is Keras and what exactly is TensorFlow. After that, we're going to differentiate between both of these terms based on few of our parameters such as architecture, prototyping, debugging, coding, performance, and a lot more. After discussing these factors, we're going to look into the pros and cons of using both Keras and TensorFlow, followed by the popularity and the job trends in both of them. Then finally, we'll conclude our video by discussing which one of them is better to choose. We'll also have a short quiz based on the video. Make sure you put down your answers in the comment section below to know if you're correct. Also guys, if you're looking to get certified in artificial intelligence, then do check out Intellipaat's AI Engineer Master course in association with IBM. The link is given in the description box. Alright guys, now without any further ado, let's get started. Alright guys, as discussed, let us begin with understanding what exactly are both Keras and TensorFlow. First, let us understand what exactly is Keras. So guys, Keras is nothing but an open source, high-level neural network library. And as it is written in Python, hence the structure of the code is easy to understand and use. This high-level API built on TensorFlow has the capability to run on top of other frameworks and libraries such as TensorFlow, Theano, CNTK, and so on, right? So being used in deep learning, it allows for easy and fast prototyping and runs smoothly on GPUs and CPUs, right? So now let us understand what exactly is TensorFlow. So TensorFlow again is an open source and free software library for data flow. It is also known as symbolic math library, and it is majorly used for machine learning applications such as neural network, and is primarily used for research and production at Google, right? So you can also say that it is flexible and comprehensive ecosystem of libraries, tools, and other resources which provide workflows with high level APIs. Moreover, it can be used for full production and deployment of machine learning pipelines. Right, so as we have discussed about the brief introduction to both Keras and TensorFlow, now let us move forward and discuss few of the parameters based on which we will differentiate between both Keras and TensorFlow. So guys, the first parameter that we have here is the architecture. So Keras has concise and simple architecture, whereas TensorFlow provides Keras as a framework that makes work more easier, right? Now the next factor that we have here is the prototyping. So in Keras, complex models can be quickly built by writing the codes, right? On the other hand, in TensorFlow, beginner can feel some difficulty writing the code from scratch itself, right? Now, the another parameter here is the coding. So guys, Keras is easier to code as it is written in Python, and TensorFlow is written in both Python and C++, and it is difficult to implement custom and new functions like activation function, etc., right? The another factor here is the debugging. So in Keras, since it deals in simple networks, hence lesser number of errors and less need for repeated debugging, right? And in case of TensorFlow, as it deals in complex neural networks, there are chances of more number of errors, which makes debugging quite difficult here. But recently, since the introduction of previous update, TensorFlow comes with an inbuilt debugger which can debug during the training as well as generating the graphs, right? Which pretty much makes things easier, isn't it? So the another factor here is the training time. So in Keras, it takes a longer duration to train the models on the same datasets, and it takes more than 2 hours for 40,000 steps of training the models. Whereas guys, TensorFlow finishes training of 4,000 steps in around 15 to 20 minutes. Sounds convenient, isn't it? Now the another factor we're going to discuss is sets of data. So as we discussed earlier that Keras deals easily with simple networks, right? So that is why Keras is used for small data sets as it is slower compared to TensorFlow. On the other hand, TensorFlow is used for large and complex data sets and high performance models, which requires the fast execution, right? Next is APIs level. So Keras is high level API and runs on top of TensorFlow as we discussed, right? Even on Theano and CNTK. It is easy to use and facilitates faster development. Whereas TensorFlow is the framework that provides both the low and high level APIs. So in huge use cases, TensorFlow provides you both level options, right? So next parameter here is the performance. So guys, in Keras, the performance is quite slow. Even if we observe the previous factors, Right. So, but TensorFlow is suitable for high performances. Now, as we have discussed the parameters, let us move forward and discuss about the benefits of using both Keras and TensorFlow.
A quick info, if you want to get certified in artificial intelligence, then do check out Intellipaat's Artificial Intelligence Engineer Master's course in association with IBM. The link is given in the description box below.
So, first of all, benefits of using Keras. So, the first benefit that we have here is the user-friendly. So, yes, Keras is user-friendly as it has consistent and simple interface which is mainly optimized for common use cases that gives clear feedback for user errors, right? The another benefit we have is the modular. In Keras, models are normally made by connecting configurable building blocks together. And it is easy to extend. In this, you can easily create or write custom building blocks for the new research and ideas. Another point to note is that it is easy to use or access. As Keras offers you simple APIs, which is used to minimize the number of user actions required for common use cases, and gives proper feedbacks to user errors, hence it is easy to use. Now, moving on to the benefits of using the TensorFlow. First thing first, it has got robust machine learning production. So guys, TensorFlow allows you to train and deploy your model effortlessly. Even if you are using different language or platform, you can use this easily. And another benefit over here is easy model building. It provides multiple levels of abstraction to train and build the models. The third point we have here is a powerful experiment for research. It offers you control and flexibility with features like the Keras functional API and model subclassing API for the creation of complex topologies. Right. So guys, as we have discussed about the benefits of using both Keras and TensorFlow, now let us move forward and discuss about the limitations of using both of them. So guys, first and foremost, limitations of using Keras. When we talk about the limitations in Keras, though it is touted as a simple interface than other frameworks, but it is difficult to work with except for the simple networks. And Keras always needs a backend framework like TensorFlow, except for a few features. Keras always needs calls to the backend, like calling directly or through the Keras backend API. Then getting out of backend calls can be very tricky. Now, the another point note here is if your inputs and outputs are not the same in the batch dimension, then Keras will always throw an error to you, right? And the fourth limitation that we have here is the calling a Keras layer from a custom layer makes those layers untrainable. So that sounds quite inconvenient, right guys? And guys, the fifth limitation that we have here is using Keras for complex networks with multiple outputs, direct calls to backend, etc. Your summary output gets broken here, right? So these are the limitations of using Keras. Now let us discuss the limitations of using TensorFlow. So the first limitation that we have here is no support for Windows. So guys, we know that there are a wide variety of users comfortable in working with a Windows environment rather than a Linux in their system, and TensorFlow does not allow these users here. As a Windows user, you will have to install it within a Conda environment or by using the Python package library or PIP, right? So the another factor to note here is TensorFlow does not support GPUs other than the NVIDIA, right? And the third point to note here is it is only supported by Python language, which makes it a huge drawback as other languages are on a rise in deep learning itself. Right guys? So if we talk about the computation speed, TensorFlow gives around 8 to 9,000 computation speed on one GPU, right? And around 12,000 on the two GPUs. And it cannot support more than two GPUs than this, right? So whereas in case of other frameworks like CNTK, it can support up to 8 GPUs and it gives around 70,000 of computational speed, guys. Right. So moreover, TensorFlow demands fundamental knowledge of advanced calculus and linear algebra along with a good understanding of machine learning also. Right guys. So guys, as we have discussed about the pros and cons in both, right? Now let us have a quick glance at their popularity and trends, right? So guys, if we talk about their popularity, then despite the above pros and cons, both of these libraries are being used in huge MNCs like Facebook, Microsoft, Google, IBM, Amazon, Accenture, Bosch, and a lot more. The list never ends. But yes, TensorFlow has got more popularity than Keras. So Keras does not fail you as per its features, but if you look at the current trends, guys, even Google says the same. It has got more number of search terms in every category, be it jobs, search, be it technology search, be it community search. With community, I mean, guys, more number of developers out there to help you or support you solve your coding problems that you're facing currently, right? Similarly, if you check on GitHub, then TensorFlow has got more number of repositories
commits, releases, branches, and contributors than Keras. Since they both are open source, you keep on getting more support from such platforms and even from different forums like Stack Overflow, etc. It purely depends on the number of users of TensorFlow and Keras. And of course, TensorFlow has more number of users than Keras. So guys, after discussing the popularity, now let's discuss about our last factor, that is, which one is better to choose here. So guys, looking at the increasing demand and growth rate of automation with deep learning in top industries, one can conclude that the use of deep neural network is definitely going to grow rapidly. So if you are interested in deep learning, then you can explore either of the framework, that is Keras or TensorFlow. So directly coming to the conclusion that one is better than the other would be a little unfair, right? As both of them have their own features and benefits of using them. Like TensorFlow is the open source and free software library for multiple tasks in machine learning, right? Whereas Keras is also an open source library of neural networks, right? Keras provides you high level APIs, but TensorFlow provides both the APIs, that is high and low level. So guys, even we discussed previously that Keras is written in Python and its coding structure and syntaxes are more user friendly as compared to TensorFlow, since TensorFlow is written in Python and C++ languages, right? But as we know, Keras is wrapper over backend libraries like TensorFlow, CNTK, and so on. So even if you are using Keras with TensorFlow in backend, ideally you are running a TensorFlow code only, right? But no doubt writing code in Keras is much easier as compared to TensorFlow. But again, it is working on TensorFlow, guys. Also guys, TensorFlow offers more advanced operations as compared to Keras, right? And it'll be very handy if you are doing any kind of research or developing work on some special kind of deep learning models. So keeping hands over both would be beneficial for you because they both are used in deep learning in every manner. So guys, TensorFlow with more number of features and more number of capabilities, it is the winner over here, right? Alright guys, now let me wrap up this session by asking you a small question over here. In the following options, what are the advantages of using TensorFlow over other libraries? Is it visualization of data? Is it scalability, pipelining, debugging facility, all of the above, or none of the above? You can let us know your answers in the comment section below to know if you're correct.
A quick info, if you want to get certified in artificial intelligence, then do check out Intellipaat's Artificial Intelligence Engineer Master's course in association with IBM. The link is given in the description box below. I hope this video was helpful to you. If you have any further queries, then do let us know in the comment section below. We will reach out to you immediately. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video and giving us your precious time. See you again.